people died in Hiroshima, 70,000 in Nagasaki. At the center of the explosion, the temperature exceeded that of 10,000 suns. Bodies, buildings, plants, trees, animals, rocks, all were incinerated. Some people left only a shadow. The term ground zero means zero time, because in 1945, scientists could not gauge accurately the milliseconds it takes for an atomic bomb to explode. Less than a second, and our world changed forever. Shigeko Sasamori knows about the effects of nuclear weapons. She was 13 years old in Hiroshima on August 6, 1945. Burned beyond recognition, it was a miracle that her family found her. Years later, as one of the Hiroshima maidens, she would come to New York City for reconstructive plastic surgery to free her chin, which was fused to her neck by the heat of the bomb. She was adopted by journalist and activist Norman Cousins and has lived most of her life in Los Angeles. She has traveled on peace boats and has been an active participant in Hiroshima Stories for the last 7 years. We in Hiroshima Stories lovingly refer to her as Baba-chan, grandmother. Please welcome Shigeko Sasamori. So, Baba-chan,
hi.
Tell us about the girls in the picture.
In the center, the teacher there, behind the teacher's left side, that shows the top of it. Can you see? Elementary school. I was just graduating elementary school. And that was 1945 in April. Then, after that, I went to the seventh grade school. That is my last picture before I get to the bond. I didn't have any scar.
And we have another slide. Tell us about the Hiroshima babies.
This is 1955. Many kind American people donated the money so we can, 25 young women came to the America to have plastic surgery. And 25 of them just leaving at Hiroshima Army airplane. Do you know where I am? Can you tell? Can you tell?
No, you did this to me earlier, and I can't find you.
There is a doctor front, Dr. Harada. Beside Dr. Harada, I'm putting him like this.
Oh.
That's me. I was 23 years old at the young time.
That's a trick question. I was looking on the steps of the airplane.
No.
Go ahead.
I still have black hair, not like a white hair now.
Okay. Next slides, please. Tell us about the students, the New York City high school students.
Yes, wonderful students. I went to many high schools. I don't remember which school was this picture. after I spoke, all the students come to me, they say, you know, words, then call me grandma. Hi, grandma. I want to take a picture with you, something like that. This is a nice looking man. They are like my grandchildren. You know, they're so young and so lovable. See, many of them. I was very happy that they.
Do you remember what you did with your name badge last year? They stuck a name badge, piece of paper.
When?
Last year, when you and I got together.
See, I'm getting older, I'm forgetting.
That makes two of us. But you remember, no, your name badge.
Oh, yes, yes, I made it up. Onizuru, in the crime. I made one of the student, right?
That's no, you, well, you made it. She made me a paper crane.
I gave it to you too.
Well, oh. You gave it to me, and then we gave it to the student.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. So the student got a used paper crane.
That's right.
But what was? We were passing. I was finished my speech, and it was your turn. And when Shigeko passed me, she just handed it out and dropped it in my hand and said, there, for you. And I gave her speech.
See, I'm getting you. Well, after all, I'm going to be 83 next month.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shigeko Sasamori. Media artist, editor, and author, performing an excerpt from his Peace Symphony featuring members of the Nouveau Classical Project and Jenny Campbell, Sarah Chen, and Chrissy Tate of Time Lapse Dance, choreographed by Jody Sperling. Paul took part as a guest speaker and artist on board Peace Boat, an international NGO that works to promote peace, human rights, and sustainable development around the world. In 2008, Peace Boat founded the Hiroshima Project, which seeks to raise awareness about the dangers of nuclear weapons and increase public support for disarmament. The project consists of inviting survivors of the atomic bombings in Hiroshima and Nagasaki to participate in around-the-world voyages to share their experiences, educate people, particularly young people, about the human cost of nuclear warfare, and call for disarmament. More than 150 Hiroshima have participated in the project. Inspired by the stories of the survivors he encountered on Peace Boat, DJ Spooky has created the work Peace Symphony, Eight Stories, weaving a sound portrait from their testimonies.
First and foremost, I just want to say it's an incredible pleasure and honor to think of not only this evening as a recall and a kind of a gathering of memory, but above all, as the way that music can help us think about what is happening in the near future. I think the human sense of scale is such that we can't imagine 10,000, 100,000 years in the future when many of the issues that face us now, whether it be Fukushima or, for that matter, Indian Point just up the river, these are the sword of Damocles over our head. So music helps us understand scale. And I think that that's something that's been not only a lesson I've learned from the Hiroshima, but the sense of human time and the dignity and the honor that they've been able to sustain and recover from the trauma of war. This piece is dedicated to my interaction with them, and the dancers are going to, I'd like to think of them as kind of the interaction of atomic particles. So we're going to get started.